Hello, everyone. Welcome to this video where we're going to talk about calibration and verification of water activity instruments. Now, calibration and verification play a very important role in maintaining your water activity instrument and making sure that it gives you good, accurate readings. Doing a calibration and verification is a great way to determine whether or not your instrument's doing what it's supposed to do. And the good news is that we have great standards that can be used for water activity instruments. These are independent standards of known water activity. So you can put them in the instrument, take a reading, and see whether or not the instrument is reading correct based upon how close it is to the reported value for the standard. And it's also important to distinguish between verification and calibration. Verification means just checking the instrument to see if it's reading within tolerance. And that's what's required is doing a verification. You only need to do a calibration, which means you're actually adjusting or shifting the numbers being produced by the instrument. And that only needs to be done if the verification doesn't read within the accepted tolerance limits. So you don't need to run a calibration every time. The system allows you to choose to do a verification as opposed to a calibration. And then if you do a verification and it's within tolerance, you go ahead and run. If it's not, then it gives you the option to be able to do a calibration. Now, the salt standards that are available for checking water activity instruments come in two types. One is saturated salt slurries. These are salts that have known water activities when they're at saturation, and unsaturated salt solutions where the water activity is based on concentration. Novacina is the only water activity instrumentation company who offers both types of standards. And each of these standards have their own pros and cons associated with them. So for instance, the saturated slurries, which we call SALT-T standards for Novacina, have the advantage of being reusable. So they can be used again and again and again. And will have a very long shelf life, 3 years or more, if you store them correctly within the containers that they come in. And so you can reuse those standards again and again, which is a great advantage. The disadvantage or the con would be that they do take longer to read, anywhere from 20 to 30 minutes to take a reading on one of these saturated standards. Alternatively, that we have the unsaturated salt standards, which come in single-use vials. These are a consumable. They are a one-time use standard. So you would empty the contents, take a reading, and then if you were going to take another reading on a standard, you would need a new vial to take a new reading. However, they run very quickly. So as opposed to a 20, 30-minute read time for the SALT-T standards, these are what we call the SALT-F standards, will run in 4 to 5 minutes. So you can get the results of your verification or to adjust your calibration in much less time using the unsaturated standards, but you do have a one-time use. So you have to continually be resupplying those standards versus the SALT-T that can be reused. So now we're going to show how you would run a calibration verification with each one of these standard types. So if we start with the SALT-T, again, these are the reusable standards. So we keep them in a container. We want to keep that container nice and tight when we're not using the standard. The standard is a disc, looks like that. And when you place it on the NEO, on the RFID chip, it will recognize what that standard is. And that's from the RFID chip that's in the bottom of the standard. So that's great. That means you don't have to worry what standard you're reading when you make the calibration adjustments. It knows and does that automatically. So when the instrument sees that standard, it will come up and tell you it sees a 75 standard and ask you if that's correct, in which case you say yes. And then it asks you, do you want to start a calibration or verification if you have that set to do verification? And then you say, okay, and it's running. So it will go through and run the standard. Again, this could be 20 to 30 minutes. Now we'll show you how to run a calibration verification using the SALT-F standards. So the process to use the SALT-F standards is a little bit different than the SALT-T. In this case, you're going to use the aluminum cup, and this comes with the calibration kit for the Salt F standards. You have several of these two of these aluminum cups that you're going to utilize to do your verification. You also need a filter pad. There's several filter pods within the box here. And within each of these cups, there's many filter pads that can be utilized. You'll take the provided tweezers and get one of those out, place it in the aluminum cup, as can be seen here. And then you'll take one of the standards. So we have our standard vials here. And we're going to open that up. And when you do, you'll see there's a seal on the standard itself. So that has to be punctured. There's a point on the lid itself that can be used to do the puncturing of that seal. So you don't need to try and rip that off. You will use that puncture to puncture it. And so if I lightly puncture that, and then I take that standard and I place it and squeeze the contents into the aluminum cup with the filter paper. And you'll notice that the filter paper then absorbs the standard. And that's how you can run these standards without having a huge amount of solution in there because we use that filter paper. So that filter paper is really important piece to this. Then you're going to take the card that comes with each one of these standards. This card's really important. You'll see it's written on there what standard it is. You want to make sure that you use the standard card for the standard that you're using. So in this case, we used a 7.5 standard, and we're going to use the 7.5 card to trigger the RFID chip. If you use the wrong card for the standard, you're going to get a calibration that comes up and says the reading is way off and your sensor health has been exhausted because you told it was 7.5, but then maybe read 8.4. So be very careful of that. So then we take our card and we put it over the RFID chip, and it comes up and says 75 detected. We verify that we are using the 7.5 standard. We take our standard we put into the cup, place it in the instrument, close the lid, answer yes, it's 7.5. And then it asks if you want to start a calibration, and we hit OK, and the calibration will run. Now, once the calibration is complete, you'll see a message come up on the screen where you can say, OK, calibration has been adjusted, or if you're using the verification setting, it will come up and tell you whether or not a calibration is needed or not. I mean, when the calibration is applied, you'll also see in that message what the sensor health is. So in summary, that's how you do a calibration verification on the LabMaster-aw water activity instrument using both the SALT-T standards, the ones that are reusable, and the SALT-F standards, the ones that are not reusable but run very quickly. We hope this video will help you in your calibration and verification process on your instrument. Thank you.